This is an evening where we honor our student athletes and our coaches regarding the spring sports season, and we will definitely honor you. But at the same time, we have the opportunity to celebrate our great community. Our community that stepped up to the plate and passed a $65 million bond issue, and at the same time passed a three-year replacement levy of almost $20 million. You add that to a bond that expires in 2021 that equals over $100 million for a district our size. What a great community. Let's hear it. Somebody put something on my door, a little note. This is us, folks. What I'm going to read, it exemplifies to its highest degree who we are as a community. Fate whispers to the warriors, you cannot withstand the storm. And the warriors whisper back, we are the storm. And it was a storm. It was a terrific storm. It was Shelton, a Shelton storm to win. People doubted we could do it. I would go to meetings and people would say, you're not going to do it. I never said a word. I had faith to the bitter end. I knew we were going to do it. I was cautiously optimistic. But we did it. And we did it because all of you took part and did everything you could to do the very best for our community, our schools, and specifically to do the very best for our students, because we care and love them and want to do the best for them as they move through their educational experience and go into life with the confidence and the skills to not only compete on the world stage, but to win. And we will win for you. At this time, I would like to introduce some people, but before I do that, I do want to recognize how many people work so hard on this campaign. And I don't want to name just certain people, because surely I will miss some very important people. But what I would like you to do right now is, if you contributed in any way to the campaign for the bond and the replacement levy, will you please stand? Let's give them my hand, folks. We thank you. Thank you for everything. This bond will take us into the future with great strength, not only in terms of facilities, but in terms of our academic program. We as a school district will stand accountable to our community. Our community has put forth and said, we care about you. We're going to give you what you need to do a great job. And I can assure you, as a school system, we are going to go full throttle to do the very best for students, to provide them a rigorous and relevant educational experience anywhere. So, thank you, thank you, thank you. At this time, I would like to introduce our board member. Everyone could be here, but Carrie Davidson, would you please come out? Carrie is our board president. Sandy Tarswell. Where's Sandy? Come on down. Sally Carr. I don't know if Ginger Stenslot is here. And Sally Brownfield, unfortunately, did not make it this evening. But I know that our board president,
Yes. On behalf of the board, we would just like to thank everyone that's here for coming tonight. Thank you to everybody who worked tirelessly to support our students and get this bond and levy passed. We really appreciate that. In the future, there's going to be community meetings and opportunities to have input. We want to invite any of you and all of you to come to those and have your voice heard. And then I would like to thank you for your tireless leadership and the direction that you've taken the school district.
Thank you very much. Next, I would like to have Dr. Mike Bernard. And of course, Don, would you please come up here too? Don and Mike were our co-chairs. They did a wonderful job. They did a terrific job. They volunteered to do it, and they did a super job. Don?
Okay, I just want to thank everybody in the crowd here in the community. I was born and raised here, and I have never seen the community come together for a cause like they have came together for the bond and the levy this year. And I really want to thank the board and Dr. Fossil for moving the school district into the 21st century.
We had an absolutely fantastic citizens committee that worked on this project. We started out with the attitude that it would pass, there was no doubt it would pass, and we would not allow it to fail, and by golly, that happened. And Dr. Apostle told me in his office months ago that he had been getting ridiculed by other superintendents who said that, in Shelton, are you kidding? But we did it, and I'm very proud.
Seen anything yet. We're just starting. Are there union representatives here? Are union reps? Come on up, Ron. Is Sheila here? Dean, are you here? Sheila, representing the classified staff.
Thank you, everybody, for everything you did.
Thank you, Sheila. And she was with us 100% all the way. She's a very important figure as it relates to graduation matters. Shelton, we're very proud of your work. Thank you, Sheila. And Ron, thank you for everything that you did, too.
This is exciting. It's already been said that the community came together. That's exciting. We have so much to look forward to. We're going to be seeing this construction started, and I'm so proud, and all the numerous hours that went into the passage of the bond and levy. So thank you, and this is going to be great.
Thank you, Ron. Thank you to all of our teachers and staff who walked the streets with signs. I'll never forget 7th and Alder. I'll never forget holding a sign in front of the, or close to the administration building. It was pretty cold, and the people I was with were getting real cold, and they were worried that I wanted to stay there too long. And I said, the next car that honks its horn will go in. Well, you know how that goes. Nobody honked the horn for a while, and I had, well, people said, I'm going to get in front of a car pretty soon, so they'll honk the horn. But people worked very, very hard. This was a team effort. People gave their all. And you know what it proves? If you go together, you can achieve anything. If we're united, we can do anything. We've proven it. And now we're going to stick together, and we're going to create the best school district in Washington State and beyond. We can do it. So many of our student athletes, and I'll tell you, to be an athlete these days is difficult because the standards that these students have to meet academically, they're pretty high. And to be a student athlete these days takes a lot of hard work. one of you a great season, and we're all very proud of you. Work hard, do your very best, and great things will happen. I thank all of you.